Welcome guys. So today's video we are going to solve some problem using the properties of Laplace transform. So you know the use of the property. The transform property is used to solve the problem in a easiest manner. Okay, so using a single step we will obtain the same answer instead of a very lengthy procedure. It is the applications of the properties of the Laplace transform. Okay, so here we solved some of the important 2-mark question problems using the properties. Okay, so you see the first problem, determine the Laplace transform of del of t minus 5 and u of t minus 5. So it is a 2-mark question. So in a single line we will solve this problem. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, so first one, so what is the first signal, del of t minus 5. So in the del of t minus 5, what is del of t minus 5? It is a delayed impulse signal by the amount 5. Okay, so it is a delayed impulse signal by the amount 5 seconds. And the next signal, u of t minus 5. So u of t, na, you know, it's a unit step signal. So u of t minus 5 means it is a delayed unit step signal by the amount 5 seconds. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, you should know the time shifting property of Laplace transform. Okay, so already the time shifting property of Fourier transform also we studied. So the same property. So what is the difference between the Fourier transform and the Laplace transform? Means in the Fourier transform, the variable is j omega. In the Laplace transform, in the place of j omega, we have to put s. Okay, that is the only difference. Okay, so for that, so what is the base signal of this del of t minus 5, del of t? So we know that the Laplace transform of del of t answer. Okay, what is the answer? 1. Okay, the standard answer, if you are taking any transform, what is the answer for the del of t signal? It is 1. If it is a Fourier transform also 1, Laplace transform also 1. So del of t, the Laplace transform answer is 1. Okay, so according to the time shifting property, so what is time shifting property of Laplace transform means? If x of t, the Laplace transform is capital X of s, means x of t minus t naught. What is x of t minus t naught? The original signal shifted by the amount t naught, where t naught is the amount of shift. It may be 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, etc. Okay, so the time delayed signal, the Laplace transform of this time delayed signal answer is that the original Laplace transform multiplied with e power minus s into t naught, where this t naught is the amount of time delay. Okay, that's all. So you should remember this property. So according to our question, we have to find the Laplace transform of del of t minus 5. Okay, so del of t, the Laplace transform answer is 1. That is, the x of s answer is 1. So now del of t minus 5, the Laplace transform answer is, so when we are comparing these two, what is t naught? T naught is, that is, the amount of delay is a 5. So the answer is, the x of s is 1 into e power minus s into the t naught value is 5. So e power minus 5s. So this answer, 1 into e power minus 5s is the Laplace transform of del of t minus 5. Okay. So similarly, we are going to solve next problem, u of t minus 5. So in the u of t minus 5, which one is a base signal? U of t, unit step signal. So the unit step signal, the Laplace transform answer, you know. What is the answer? 1 divided by s. Okay, these are all the standard answer you should remember. U of t, Laplace transform answer is 1 by s. So according to this time shifting property, u of t minus 5, the Laplace transform is the same x of s answer multiplied with e power minus s t naught. Here, what is t naught? T naught is the amount of delay. It's a 5. So e power minus 5s. So this 1 by s, e power minus 5s is the Laplace transform answer for the problem u of t minus 5. Okay, so it is a thing. So similar to this problem, so one more problem, it's a May 2011 question. Determine the Laplace transform of u of t minus 2. Okay, so the u of t minus 2 is a time delayed unit step signal by the amount 2. Okay, so first we know that u of t, the standard signal u of t, the Laplace transform is 1 by s. So according to the time shifting property of Laplace transform, first we have to write the time shifting property. That is x of t minus t naught, the Laplace transform answer is x of s multiplied with e power minus s t naught. Okay, so therefore the u of t minus 2 is what is x of s? This 1 by s. So 1 by s into e power minus, what is the t naught value? T naught value is at 2. So e power minus 2s. Okay, the same way here u of t minus 5 the quotient, here u of t minus 2 is the quotient. Okay, this is the thing. Then the next question, find the Laplace transform of x of t equal to e power minus 5t u of t minus 1. Okay, so we have to solve this problem using property, or otherwise in a ordinary procedure we may solve. Okay, so what is the given signal? The given signal is a e power minus 5t, so exponentially decaying signal, and this exponentially decaying signal is multiplied with u of t minus 1. Okay, if the signal is multiplied with only with the u of t, means you know the signal is available for the time t equal to 0 to t equal to infinity. But here it is multiplied with u of t minus 1. What is u of t minus 1? It is a time delayed unit step signal by the amount 1. Okay, that means this u of t minus 1 signal is available from time t equal to 1 to infinity. Okay, that's why the integration limit is from 1 to infinity. That is the only difference. Okay, if u of t problem means integration 0 to infinity. Here u of t minus 1 means this signal, the entire signal is available only from 1 to infinity. So the integration 1 to infinity, what is the x of t? E power minus 5t into e power minus st dt. Okay, so here there are two e power terms there. So you just combine the e power term. So we can write like this. So you integrate it, and if you are substituting the upper limit, infinity means we will get the answer as 0. Okay, so minus of, we have to substitute the lower limit. What is the lower limit? 1. So in the place of t, we have to put 1. So e power minus s plus 5 divided by minus of s plus 5. So this minus minus plus. So we will get the answer e power minus s plus 5 divided by s plus 5. So this is the answer. Okay, this is the answer for this problem. And the next one is find the initial and final value of x of s equal to 1 divided by s plus 1. Okay, so how to solve this problem means in Laplace transform, there is a theorem, initial value theorem and final value theorem is there. Okay, so here the question is, we have to find the initial and final value of the Laplace transform answer x of s equal to 1 divided by s plus 1. Okay, so what is the time domain signal for this given Laplace transform answer? So the structure is 1 by s plus a. Okay, so for which signal the Laplace transform answer is 1 by s plus a? So you know e power minus a t u of t. So the time domain signal for the given x of s is e power minus t u of t. So what is e power minus t u of t? It is an exponentially decaying signal. So you know for the exponentially decaying signal, what is the initial value? Initial value means at a time t equal to 0, what is the amplitude of the particular signal? It is 1. Okay. What is the final value? Final value means at a time t equal to infinity, what is the signal is having the value? Means it is 0. Okay. So the initial value is 1. The final value is 0. Okay. But now we are going to solve this problem in Laplace transform. Okay, so in Laplace transform, there is an initial value theorem is there. So according to this theorem, the initial value small x of 0, that is small x of 0 means at a time t equal to 0, the answer for the time domain signal is calculated by the formula is that limit s tends to infinity s into x of s. This is the formula. Okay, the initial value small x of 0 is calculated by limit s tends to infinity s into s x of s. Okay, over here limit s tends to infinity s into, what is the given x of s? 1 by s plus 1. Okay, you just substitute here. Okay, so in this thing, wherever the s term is available, we have to substitute infinity. But if you are substituting directly infinity to that s, means infinity divided by infinity, so the answer is not at all indeterminate value. So that's why maximum we have to reduce this expression. Okay, so here out of this s plus 1, I am taking s as a common. Okay, so if you are taking s as a common, we have to write 1 plus 1 by s. So here this s cancelled. So now we have to substitute the remaining 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by s, we have to substitute s equal to infinity. So if you are substituting s equal to infinity, here means we will get 1 by 1 plus 1 by infinity. What is 1 divided by infinity? 1 divided by infinity is 0. Okay, so 0 plus 1, 1. So 1 divided by 1, 1. Okay, so the initial value of the given signal is 1. We obtained using initial value theorem. Okay, similarly, the final value is calculated using the final value theorem. So according to the final value theorem of Laplace transform, the final value means x of infinity, that is x of t at t equal to infinity, okay, is calculated by limit s tends to 0 s into x of s. Okay, you see the difference. Initial value is calculated by in s into x of s, we have to substitute s equal to infinity. The final value is calculated by in s into x of s, you substitute s equal to 0. Okay, so limit s tends to 0, s into x of s values 1 by s plus 1. Okay, so now similarly, you take s as a common, here s is cancelled. Now in the place of s, you substitute 0. So 1 divided by 0, it is infinity. So infinity plus 1, infinity. So 1 divided by infinity, what is the answer? It is a 0. So the final value is 0. Okay. So this is the initial and the final value calculation using Laplace transform. Okay. So these are all the some of the important problems using the properties of Laplace transform. Okay. So thanks for watching. And please subscribe my channel for more videos and share this video to your friends. Thank you. Keep watching my channel. Thank you.